This is an update on KPO Phase 2, specifically the construction of the Rolloff Observatory building that will house the KPO 18-inch reflector. I started the Rolloff building after completing the observing deck, which was done in February of this year. Picked up a load of lumber and plywood and started framing out the walls. The initial rollback tests were easy because the building didn't weigh too much yet. That would change. I started the roof frame, which was a simple 3-4-5 pitch using a single 12-foot 2x6 for the ridge. Roofing is always difficult for me, and I always use a ladder laid over the peak to do all the work. One of the hardest things about building construction is doing the soffits. You're always drilling and pounding nails upward, which is very strenuous. As I live on a farm, the goats are always trying to sneak onto the observatory field for a snack. With the addition of the doors, the building is essentially dried in and is basically rainproof. I did a test graphic by editing a photo just to see what the color scheme would look like. The reality was pretty close. After a massive amount of caulking and painting, the exterior was finished, so I can now move on to doing the minimal electrical work that was needed to support the building. I took power from the east exterior outlet of the main observatory building and ran conduit under the ground and finally mounted on the joists under the deck. My old friend Rob Conway came to assist and installed the interior and exterior lights. I installed a temperature-controlled exhaust fan to keep the building cooler and to battle the Florida heat. Because the entire building rolls back, I use an equipment power socket to connect the building to the main service point. There is one socket in the rear of the building for the interior light and the fan, and one near the front for the exterior red lighting. As usual when you're constructing a building, after electrical is done, you can proceed with the insulation. I added a layer of R13 in the ceiling to reduce the heat radiating through the roof. Next up was the construction of the stand-up desk that will hold the computer, telescope drive system, and other items. I stained the desk and then added interior-exterior carpet over the wood floor. That finished the building. All that was left was to move the KPO reflector from the main dome down to the observing deck. My buddy Rob helped again with the disassembly and moving of the scope. I thought that was great because he helped with the installation of the scope in the main KPO dome over 10 years ago. Here we're getting ready to remove the 125 pounds of counterweight. We had to make sure that everything would go right here so nothing or no one would be damaged. In the end, the counterweights came off just fine. Next step was to remove the top of the telescope cradle by removing the wing nuts holding it to the other half of the cradle. This would basically free the optical tube from the mount. Yes, I got it. I'm going to go to the bus. I'm going to go to the bus. The next delicate procedure was to lower the 95-pound optical tube from the rolling platform down to the observatory floor. We rearranged a bit and then lugged the optical tube down to the studio office. Next off was to remove the lower cradle section from the mount. Then we disassembled the mount, which is composed of the declination axis housing and the polar housing, which is quite a hefty chunk of metal. We spent about an hour cleaning up the mountain telescope, which had become a home for mud wasps over the last 10 years. I got all the nests out and cleaned it all up so it looked like new. Finally, it was time to take all the scope components out to the new observing deck and get it assembled. I rolled back the building to get our work area clear. I'm still working on the track to get it rolling smoothly. I've installed a boat winch that I can use to crank the building back, and it works pretty well. So here comes the mount. First of all, the heavy polar housing, and then the somewhat lighter declination housing. It amazes me that I used to take this scope all around the Southeast United States for star parties and set it up in a matter of a couple hours. Here, Rob places the lower telescope cradle onto the declination shaft of the mount. And out comes the main optical tube. With two people, this is an easy task. We place the tube on a small wooden box and then slide the scope onto the cradle. Then we attach the top cradle and secure it with wing nuts. The scope rotates in this cradle on felt so that the eyepiece can be rotated to the best observing position possible. Now we're preparing to mount the counterweights on the end of the declination shaft of the mount. The counterweights are secured with set collars with locking nuts that screw into drilled detents in the shaft to prevent the weights from falling off. So finally, the proper balance is set and the scope can be rotated up. Now I can proceed with wiring and final details. Next steps in the project is to start the boardwalks and bathroom, and then add railings everywhere. My goal is to have all this done by October, when we can start to hold private observing sessions out on the observing deck. See you for the next update.
Here's the scope in the interior of the Rolloff building. It's very, very tight, but it works.
So this is the scope in the home position to be able to open the, roll back the building.